my darlings, my name is Silva. Dorkable, I am your friendly monster waifu, and I realized that the background noise is not coming through for some reason. So let me see. Should be coming through. It is, it's just very quiet. So how is everyone? There you are. There we go. Much better. How's it going, Data? So today we are going to be kind of playing around with Vroid Studio, which is a program that I use for my VTuber model. It's a pretty well-known program, and they actually have gotten pretty popular ever since they released their official studio, version. So this is the current model that I have. I'm good. So, ultimately, you might have seen this model lurking around in the Creativerse. Should be a poser to show exactly what this looks like. There we go. So more or less, you can see exactly what the character looks like. You can put them in different poses. See exactly what they look like from various different angles. You can change the background, you can change the lighting, things like that. More or less, this is just to preview in live time exactly what the character looks like. You'll notice that I kind of just put something generic on her for the meantime. I wasn't really sure what I wanted to do. I just wanted something I could put into Creativerse. So ultimately, we are going to be playing with everything from... I wouldn't necessarily say from scratch, but for the sake of this, we will probably go ahead and do a new one. Or at least play with it to see if I can make it a little bit more enjoyable to me. So, let's see. Because I don't know, the more I think about it, the more I'm like, oh, is she too generic looking? Rotate the eyes, make her sadder, more evil looking. Use inner slant. Outer eye slant. Lower eyelid. I kind of like it like that. So angry. Oh god, that is kind of horrifying when you look at it like that, isn't it? It's a little bit larger. Just me, or is it like a weird looking glassiness to her eyes? I can't help it. I have to see this. Oh my god. She looks so stupid. Oh, Silva, what happened to you? Oh, poor girl. Poor sweet child. Okay, we're gonna fix that. That's... Ugh. Come on, shut back up. There we go. There we go, that's better. Oh, God. Oh. Problem with the eyebrows, the nose necessarily. So the great thing is this, the Vroid Studio comes with a lot more pre-made facial structures. So if I wanted to, technically I could choose one of these and it would give me a facial structure. Thing is, I'm not really sure if I want any of these facial structures, so it's kind of nice being able to go back, look, and then go back, look, and then go back. I do have a tendency to like the more adult look in the fact that her face goes up a little, or her eyes go up a little higher on her face, which makes her look less childlike. I love how they have, like, all these females and, like, three males, from what I can tell. Does make me wonder though. I feel like now that I'm looking at it, her jaw is a little. Let's see. Ear tip, ear size, teeth shrink. Oh, yeah. Mess with the jaw. Oh my god, those. No. Like how you can make it a oh god no. Apparently, feminine eyes are drooped more. Eyebrows are up, and masculine eyebrows are down. That's good to know. Feminine. Like some of these are a little weird when you think about it, but cockroaches born in space are stronger and faster than the ones born in Earth. Well. That's, that is kind of a little creepy. So I do like that you can essentially mess with all these. So, let's mess with these. Great thing is, I happen to have a huge thing of Vroid stuff that I have accumulated over the time. So let's see. What do I like? She has blue and green eyes, so let's see. Okay. Or that. tail eyes. Ooh, that's kind of cool. Actually, that is kind of cool. That's kind of cool. Over that. Let's take a look at another one. So essentially, the great thing is I can mix and match all these different eyes because it goes off of, how do I explain it? It goes off of each side. Ooh, I really like those. So for example, I would get one blue and one green. And those are both the same style, they're just different colors, which is kind of useful. More or less, though, you can put virtually any color you want. I have a large portion of veritable older things that I've put in here. One at a time, I don't like that one. And more or less, I can go through and find the ones I like, find the ones I don't like. I like this one, it's too light. Find the ones I like, find the ones I don't like, get rid of them, narrow them down until I essentially have whatever I've decided works for me. Which is great because it's pretty easy, actually. Because there's just so many, I don't really have to worry about finding, you know, a bunch. And you can hand paint these too, don't get me wrong. But I just didn't kind of feel like it, if that makes sense. Those are the demon eyes that I already had up there. Try these. Those are pretty. Problem is with having so many to choose from is you essentially have so many to choose from, and after a while you don't really know what you want necessarily versus what looks good versus where you're like, oh, I just kind of like them because I like them. And it gets to be a little bit much. Kind of like these. Yeah, it's kind of like giving someone the option of picking from like 20 things or like 10 things. It's going to be easier to pick from the 10 things because there's only 10. Whereas if you have 20 things to pick from, you're probably going to be browsing for a while longer. Great thing is, if I find one that I genuinely really like, I can always open it in Photoshop and just edit the color. There's nothing that really stops that. Oh, there's hearts. But this is kind of where you get the various differentials and things that make the character look customized is through the reskinning or retexturing. So let's see. More that have the demon cat eye thing are a little challenging. Oh, where are these? Oh, those are gems. Good to know. Problem is, I like a lot of them, so ultimately I have a couple that I use specifically for Silva, which would be... Where are you? Where the hell are you? thought I had a couple I used specifically for Silvergirl, and I don't. Thought I had a couple I specifically used for her, but damn, now I'm not so sure. Where the hell's my stuff? I'm gonna find them, give me a second. Honestly, it's not hard. Like, that's what it is. Honestly, it's not hard. You can literally download this for free. Oh, look at that. So that is where that glassy color is coming from. So we can actually erase that glassiness. Kind of like that clear, translucent layer that doesn't really make sense around the iris. There we go. That's better. Yeah, actually, I use Windows 10, and yeah, this works 100% on Windows 10. This is absolutely 100% free. It is available on Steam. Eye highlights. So the great thing about eye highlights is you can add various different eye highlights. So let's see. Let's add some eye highlights, which should be in eyes. Like, essentially, this is adding things onto the eye highlights, or highlights, or eyelights. Eyelights? Shine. The shine of the eyes. Great thing is you can actually layer all these things on top of each other. That is pretty nice. You can actually layer these things on top of each other. So if you want like a ridiculous amount of eye highlights, or you want like specific eye highlights, like these are very like anime-ish, like 1990s anime, you can essentially layer. Like these are, you know. I don't quite like how a lot of these are fully opaque. Don't like that. Don't like the fully opaque. Ooh, that's shiny. I don't know what the hell that is. Honestly, I have a lot of fun with it. It kind of helps when I hit a rut and I'm just like, oh, I don't know what the hell I want to do anymore, and like, I don't know what I expect to do as far as, what's the word? I inspiration. So like, for example, you can take that layer opacity and take it all the way down. Take that layer opacity. Put it like there, and take that layer opacity. Put it like there. See, I don't know. I kind of like that one a little more. You can kind of see, but at the same... Yeah, I kind of like that one. Then that one, the drawing mode, can actually be different ones. Multiply. Problem is that they're white, so... There we go. And then these, let's see. So what we can do with this, fun fact, if I can find it, there is actually, should I get Stardust Eyes? There's actually different versions of Solaris that you can use depending on exactly what you want the eyes to look like. So, for example, if I was going to be doing Demon, I would probably use Black Solaris. Like that. Which are very, kind of creepy. Honestly. Kind of super creepy. It honestly doesn't fit with that, so... Eyebrows. I feel like the eyebrow needs to be a little bit of a different color. Ah, there we are. Better. Eyeliner. So you can actually change the eyeliner, which is kind of nice. And change exactly how you want it to look, and then you have eyelashes. Mouth inside. Okay. Wait, no, that's not what I want. Like, yeah. Well, have fun, Data. Don't worry, I'll just be here. Let's try this eyeliner. Is I've always had trouble differentiating the files that are for eyeliner with the files that are for eyelashes. And it's not that they're necessarily that different. It's just a matter of recognizing which files are which files. Play with the eyelashes. So eyelashes you can actually do in different colors as well. If I can find them, I've seen some that are very interesting. If I can find them. Brow, highlight, brow, lashes. Okay, I'm not really noticing any difference on that. question is... Oh, there we go. Just going through them one at a time is kind of what you have to do sometimes. Ah, creepy spider eyes. I don't like it. Supposed to be eyeliner though. See, like, I like these. I don't really like whatever the hell that is. Let's see. Fix these. That doesn't bother me as much. Nice, Joey. I actually saw that. I'm really excited for you. Did you use V-Roid for that? V-Roid Studio is actually what I'm using right now. Yeah, it's pretty nice, right? nice, VC Face. I don't think that's the one I use. I forget exactly what the one I use is, but I kind of felt like I needed to renovate mine a little bit. It's been a while. Eyelashes. Ah, it's horrible. Buenos nachos. Good nachos. One of these are kind of ugly. Then again, I think it also depends significantly on the type of model you're going for, and obviously if you're not going for one type of model and you're going for another kind. Seems pretty normal. Aha, the skin, okay. So this is where you can actually import different stuff. So, where was it? I saw that there was like a gothic eye shadow, and I was like, that probably looks horrible. But I still want to try it. I want to look at it, so that I can go, no. Want the option. Ah! That doesn't work with the smaller eyes that I have, does it? Ugh. Stand by what I said. No. So there are a lot of different, like, there are a lot of different colors you can use. Thank you. Like, I don't have anything against most of them. They're very beautiful. Most of them. But, again, it kind of depends on the style of the face that you have. Because obviously if you have a certain set of proportions and the makeup isn't set for that, like with that goth makeup, it ends up looking, like, super creepy. Oh, hey, blue. I could be blue if I wanted. Or just totally pale. That's cool too. Let's see. Honestly, I'm probably not going to go with anything different. I just kind of feel like I want to go over this since I'm already going over like the clothing and everything. I just feel like it would be, you know, a nice opportunity to take a look and go, is this really the face I want? Not that it really matters, because you can't stop this. Just saying. Some of these are a little creepy. Just try to the makeup. Let's look at the makeup. Just makeup. Sarah Dynamite, I like that. That was horrifying. Okay, I need to give a normal skin style before I decide to do that, because that is creepy to not have any face. God, imagine not having a face. Face at all. There's just nothing. Okay, let's see. Where is a generic? God, the lipstick's so tiny. Like, I don't get it. Why are they so tiny? Have that tiny of nose? I'm more like a. I can't really. There's eyeshadow, which probably is going to be totally misplaced. Not as misplaced as I thought it would be. Also, doesn't look quite as bad as I thought it would. Like a khaki or something. Something that doesn't quite look as. Okay. That's not bad, actually. Did not express the eyebrow or eyeshadow to look good. This. Hanfu, huh? Again, tiny little lips. Tiny little lips. Why tiny little lips? Oh, and then the little, like, Shikon jewel going on. Well, it's not bad. It's not great either. Lipsticks, which are too small. Skin tones, which I don't need. More eyeshadow. Eyeshadow actually doesn't look that bad. That eyeshadow looks bad. Weird constellation dust. Looks like... I mean, I guess it depends on how difficult of a Vaporeon model it is, because most of what I do is just stuff that I piece together from what I get on booth. So it wouldn't be like anything truly 100% custom, but I mean, yeah, I'd throw together something. It wouldn't be magnificent, wouldn't be custom, wouldn't be hand-painted, because I've seen some people that do custom Vroid models that are like, oh my god, they're gorgeous. But, yeah, I mean, if they got me the pieces they wanted and they were just like, I wanted to look like this, I'd be like, yeah, okay. Because it's honestly not that difficult to do something like that, but when it comes to making stuff from scratch, that's outside of my jurisdiction. I'm not quite that good. I still stick to 2D art. The hell is that? That looks horrifying. Yeah, pretty horrifying. Honestly, I don't know. I just kind of felt like I wanted to work on my Vroid model. I get confused a lot with someone else who does a Vroid model. It's kind of frustrating. Even though she's, like, super sweet, it's still frustrating. Because I genuinely try to be original to some extent or another. It just doesn't necessarily... This doesn't necessarily work because, you know, I guess you could say they're more popular than I am, so people are like, oh, you're so-and-so, and I'm like, I'm not that person. So I don't know, sometimes I'm like, well, do I need a more unique-looking character? Like, I don't want it to look like a DeviantArt OC that has, like, 12 sets of wings and, like, 42 different tattoos, and, like, my hair's in, like, 27 different colors, but at the same time, like... Is it not enough? Like, I don't know. So right now, we're just kind of going through, seeing what we can find, what kind of interests me right now. I'm seeing a lot more eyes I like, which is great, but... doesn't really help me because we've already passed that phase. Let's see, and the hair textures we'll get to. I've seen some people that hand paint their textures onto their model, and it's just like, damn, that is pretty. But I don't want to. Mostly because I use iPad, and since I use an iPad and Vroid Studio isn't for iPad, I essentially have to, like, take it and transfer it over and then do it and then transfer it back, and it's just kind of a pain in the ass. I mean, I have a tablet. It's right over there. I'm just super lazy and I don't want to use it because I got spoiled on my iPad. My iPad has such better haptics when it comes to, like, responsiveness and just being better. And I just kind of, like, try using my digital tablet, and I'm just like, this is shit. So given the opportunity, I will definitely choose the iPad. But if it's a necessity, I'll struggle. Eyeshadow. God damn it. Eyeshadow. Brown. Let's go back. I saw some new eyelashes, as if I fucking need them. Because I... Was it eyelashes or was it eyeliner? It wasn't eyelashes. Eyeliner. As if I fucking need them. Because apparently, like, I have a million things in 27 different places, and I don't know what the hell to do. Forget it. Forget it. It's good. It's good. Skin, face paint, expression editor, neutral, nope. Smiling, yep, sad. I feel like angry should be. Where's the scornful look? Hide highlight. Oh, that's kind of nice. Okay, that's actually kind of cool. We're gonna play with this. Move to back? I don't know what the hell that means. Thank you. you surprised on those?
Oh, God.
Gonna save before I forget any of that. I should ask how everyone is doing. Oh wow, there's a lot more people. Seems to be working. There's a lot more people than I expected. Let's see. Seema. Violet's TV. Zephyr. Welcome all of you that I'm throwing around because it's fun. Boop. Oh, are we sound saving? Perfect. Okay, so the great thing about Vroid Studio is it actually has some prefabricated hair. Now, granted, I already have these set, which is good. So if I choose one, it's not really going to change too much. So you do have some, you know, enjoyable little things, kind of nice. Oh, I kind of like that one. It's actually very similar to what I already have. Now, granted, these are full hairstyles. It's very Hatsune Miku. But what we could do is choose none. Kind of creepy looking. Then go by front, so we can essentially choose the different front pieces. You can actually choose the different hairstyles that you think look good. I think this is something similar to what I had originally edited. The great thing is you can edit the hairstyle, so if I want it to be higher, I can. It's a very Hime high hair. Hime hairstyle. Hime? Hime. 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 So, like, let's say I wanted to do this one, edit hairstyle, and I want to make it. Can't make it shorter, can't I? God. It's even worse. Let's go back to what we had. Okay. So that's essentially what I have. I can kind of edit it. I feel like I should edit it. We're going to save it before we edit it, and then we're to adjust the freehand grip. You can adjust every single one of these. Cool and suppy. There we are. So you can do some. You can. Ha 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 ha. Okay. Close without saving. So we are gonna do it. We're gonna fix what we were gonna do because I knew there was a way. I knew it. I don't know what the hell I just did here. We're gonna fix it. Not what I wanted. So, by doing this, we can essentially change it to be a little bit better when it comes down to it. I think it's this one. Ah, go back. Sons of bitches. There we go. Actually going to edit this and kind of make it more sweepy. Change the width on this. Mm-hmm. Was the Pope ever a rock star? I don't think so. Also, how's it going, John Smith? Edit the cage. Thank you. I think that looks... I actually have been kind of entertaining the thought of a ponytail again. She actually had a ponytail when I started the stream. I've just been trying to mess with this hairline. Technically speaking, yes, she does have human ears. However, we hide them because we don't want her having human ears. Actually, So basically, we went from this to that, which I'm kind of happier with. Great thing is, you can actually adjust all these things separately now. Example, like, I like these because they kind of cover her, her not ears. However, we also have those, those. I think we're going to continue with these, but we will edit them to be a little bit better. I can't help it. I don't know, like, I feel the need to fix this shit. Let's see. Those are smaller. Those are in the back. I like the back ones. God damn it. Sometimes the program is not exactly ready to, cope with some of the things I want to do. You know what? Actually, I just realized. Honestly, I'm pretty happy with her so far. I mean, granted, it's no custom-made model from, there we go. Ooh, it's kind of ugly. I don't like that at all. Never mind. Granted, it's no custom model made from scratch, but, I mean, it's a pretty good opportunity to have a VTuber model that, allows you to express yourself, and, come on, go, god damn, that one always gets me. Hmm. hell happened there? That's what happens when you edit something from the front. Doesn't know how the hell to react to anything. Change, but a little bit. Let's go to the back. There's a lot you can do with the back, so let's see. Could always give her short hair. I know a lot of people really like short hair. I don't know. Short hair's not as fun to draw. There's always that. Just nice long hair. You know, Silva originally had pigtails. She had like two pigtails that were like down here. I do like how fluffy that is, I'll be honest. But it's awfully nice. It's beautiful and fluffy, and I love it. But it's so short. There's also that, which is just normal. I love this. Like, I love this, but I wish it was significantly longer. And I don't feel like there's an easy way to make it longer. Essentially, that is the style for having tall hair. There we go. Oh, I do like that one. I forgot about that one. It's a little messy, though. Tried, in case you can't tell, I tried a couple times to make it like, I love long down hair, but at the same time I hate drawing hair of the down. It's a pain in the ass. And then overall hair, no. Got like buns. Messy buns. Pigtails. That's the one I was working with. I was using that. Which I gave it. There we go. That was what I was originally using. And I kind of like it. I like the hair being up. I don't know. I feel like it looks better. Kind of made it a little bit more voluminous. Desperately need to fix whatever the fuck that is. Overall hair, not overall hair, back. Edit hairstyle, I need to edit. Where the hell is the thing that justifies what the fuck color that is? Oh, no, trust me. This one, I really don't feel like I need a highlight. Hair bounce? Maybe. I don't really feel like I need a highlight for this one. Oh, look. Bloop. 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 Oh, that actually might be kind of useful. Okay. Don't know what the fuck I just did, but now let's edit that because I want it down a little bit. Like, it sticks up too much and I don't like it. Honestly, I still need to go through and do a highlight reel on my second episode of Five Nights at Freddy's. So really, you're not missing anything. Like, you're totally fine. You have plenty of time. Base hair, there we are. There we go. Save that. Starting to slowly like how this is turning out. Slowly. Little bit by little bit. Still kind of think I need to change the eyes. So body, did I put, no, I didn't put little paws on her. So I've been thinking of putting little paws on her again, because she used to have little paws on her hands and on her feet. I don't really want to mess with anything with the body until I do the outfit. Then I have accessories. Oh, that reminds me, I need to try to do a tail. So, let's see how that works. A good Christmas gift this year? Depends on who you're buying it for, honestly. This right there. Okay, that goes up. Okay, yep, so I think that goes. I'm trying to essentially invert this. I don't think that's as easy as it sounds. I wonder if I can just not invert it and just move it down. I I know this doesn't make sense right now. Just give me a minute. Yeah, okay. That's not going to make any sense, but whatever. We're going with it anyway. I'll adjust it in a minute. This is essentially the frame in which the hair follows. Oh. Nope. Don't want it. There we go. Okay, so. Okay. We need to fix the mesh first. Oh, don't do this to me. Don't freeze. Please don't freeze. I know I'm asking a lot of you. Thank you. Okay, what are we having problems with right now? Say that trying to figure out what ones connect to what is very challenging. You know what? Let's not. There we go. Okay. Let's not do the circle around yet. Just make everything even for a minute. Okay, this we can work with. Okay, I know that. God damn it. I know it's very confusing. But. Actually, you can export models from this and put them into Blender. Okay, so that's the beginning. Then we want to. Oh, no. Basically, you're trying to create an upside down V, if that makes any sense. Go somewhere in there. This, no. There we go. That one. Yes. I figured it out. I have inverted it. It only took me more time than known to man, but I get it. Okay, so that is essentially the cone that you have to draw the book in. So it takes excuse me? No, that's not. That's not what I just did. It essentially takes you to import it. I don't think. Oh, that's why. Okay. I was like, I don't think that's what it looks like. But yeah, that's what it looks like. I twisted it, that's why. There we go. Smart. They are smart. So, as everyone knows, Silva has two tails, which are essentially joined at the base. So, we want to make sure the width is good, the thickness is good. That's the wrong side. Also, we don't want that. Son of a bitch, stop letting go. You know what, you're just... me the fuck off. That's what you're doing. Pissing me the fuck off. But you know what? We'll fix this. We'll fix it. That's not what I wanted. Start in the base. What the? Oh! Of course. one thing I don't like about dealing with something that is three-dimensional is sometimes they don't like... Well, that works. Sometimes they don't like working in the way you want them to. How's it going, Thork? Okay, so let's see if I can make this actually do what I want it to now. There we go. So essentially, what we can do now is shape this. There's another one I missed. Like how. Together because I like the tail to have almost a blunt end. I don't know if I really like having the tails. It's kind of... I be a little better. Oh, there we go. Thickness. Maybe not quite that wide. There we go. No twist. Very smooth. Okay, we're getting there. We're getting there. It's taking a little while, but we're getting there. Kind of like that. I really like whatever the hell's going on right there, but not that. That's what's going on right there. Like that. So we're going to duplicate this one. Someday. Someday we'll duplicate it. And we're going to I'm kind of happy with it so far. So far. God, I really hope that it works. It doesn't like just start flopping around everywhere. I do this the more I realize it. Don't look as good as I thought they would. Procedural here, good. Now, I could have sworn there was also an area where I can add some texture. Find some good hair. I don't like the shininess. Like, is it possible just to get rid of the shininess? Because it is creepy as hell. Highlights. Oh! No highlight. Kinda fucked. I just choose not to have any. It's those highlights. I am a picky artist. I don't understand why it's so shiny. Where's the shine? Damn it! I'm gonna figure it out, just not right now. I'll figure it out later. I'll figure out how to get rid of the shading later. Oh, of course I have both. Oh, wait a minute. God, those look ugly. And they clip through her. We are not doing that. We are going to go back with the other thing I was looking at. Forget the tails. No, not doing it. Not doing the tails. Nope. No. What did I just say? There we go. Things are just pissing me off, man. So the great thing is, you can technically have, like, full outfits on this that are already, that are already not flattering. Like, really not flattering. Well, that's actually kind of cute. But, ultimately, I have some stuff I already kind of work with. So, part of me wants to try to make, like my character, the drawings that I've lately made have like a slit skirt, and unfortunately it's really difficult because there's so much extra space. I do have some really cute outfits, like, by the way, I actually am wearing this shirt today, but that's irrelevant. Some of these do not work for certain body types, might I add. Like, some of them really don't work for certain body types. And I don't know, like, part of me kind of was like, oh man, I really want, like, a certain style. Actually really found this cute. This is what it used to be. I used to wear that. I don't know, like, it just... But, I don't know, I find, like, this actually is a possibility. I have to custom make it, though, because I'll essentially have to custom... Oh! I could technically make the... I could technically make the tails part of her dress. And, like, have them laying down. Anyway. Because, yeah, I was playing with the fact of possibly doing that, because at least that way it fits correctly. But, I have a lot of, like, little other outfits that I've kind of already thrown on looking at and stuff, and I'm just like, ugh. We have dresses. I have dresses, so let's see. That's kind of... See, that's what happens when you try doing it as a dress. It flares out no matter how much you try to narrow it, and it just doesn't, it just doesn't. I'll tell you that right now, it doesn't. It just doesn't work. It doesn't work. Aw, thank you, Mama. Uh-oh. I have to sneeze. Sorry, I didn't want to blow anyone's eardrums out. So I don't know. I've been kind of like entertaining the thought of doing like a custom outfit. But I haven't really figured out what I want. How's it going, A? This one has wings on it. Little wings. But I haven't really figured out exactly what it is that I want. Because I'm just like, I don't know what the fuck I want. These are all, like, cute things I've gotten from various different places. I really like this one. But my character isn't really, you know, a Shinto maiden or anything. I liked the cut of this one. But ultimately I was like, it's still... But there's always, like, little things like that. I can make her... Now, I do have some outfits that I can try. Let's see. Inner tops. Socks. Take her socks off. These socks are actually on the skin layer. I also have custom shoes. Like, my custom boots. My custom bootsies. These are my custom little, little sockies. Let's see what I have. Where are you? Okay. Let's see, I have some clothes. I just have to decide what the fuck I want to dress in. I think, if I'm not mistaken... One thing I've wanted to do, and it's very frustrating because I don't think I can do it, is I want to give her something that the character has, and it's very frustrating because I can't really make it work because it's a shawl, but I want it to like go across the back and then across here, but I can't really do that because, I mean... It would essentially detach from her sides, given the fact that it's not a jacket. If that makes sense. Because I think I'd essentially have to use a jacket, but the thing is, it's not a jacket. It's a shawl, so it would have to be connected. But at the same time, if it's not connected, it doesn't work, and. Thank you, Mama. The black dress is what I went with for the longest time. I'm probably still gonna go with it to some extent. I just have to decide what I essentially want to do. Where was it? I thought I saw... See if I can make it work. So, essentially, I don't think that's the right. I don't think that's the right style. It should be. Maybe it's on skin. Literally me when I'm trying to do virtually anything that I don't know what I'm trying to do. It's very frustrating. Let's see. Because there are some very nice outfits. However, I cannot seem to get half of the stuff I want to. Now, the great thing is, technically speaking, I could sketch on this where I want something. And ultimately, I'd be able to use that in order to get the outline of what I want. Kind of like what I did with the skirt. That's not the skirt. That's the bottoms. Kind of like what I did with this, where I clipped it until it was... How's it going, Ben? Until it was in a shape that I wanted it to be. Problem is that they don't really have anything like that, which is great because it means that I'm making something new. Also kind of sucks because at the same time, can you layer this? No. You can't put bottom. Okay. You can't put bottoms over. Can you put tops? So I've already used that. Can I put a top over? I can. I can indeed. Wow. I kind of wish I could manage to get 11k views. I have never had 11k views on just one of my videos. I don't know why or why not. I don't know what... I honestly just don't know what to say to that. Except for maybe crying myself to sleep. This is Summers With You. It is available on Pretzel. I wish I could figure it out, but I just sort of do what I do and hope for the best. Apparently, that's probably not how you do it, because I feel like if that was the case, I probably would have had it by now. I also realized I forgot to do the hair texture. So we're gonna go back to you for now. We're gonna go back to the hairstyle because I want to mess with the hair texture. This one. Yeah, I mean, ultimately, it would be nice to know what the hell I'm doing wrong, but... Okay, so we are going to try some other textures and see how they work. Because the textures are essentially what makes everything change. It's actually really pretty. Obviously changing that doesn't matter. But if I need to, I can technically change these colors as necessary. Also making that a little bit darker. Well, that is true. Yeah, I don't know, honestly. Sometimes it just kind of feels like I'm, beating my head against the wall, you know? That is one option. So while I'm here, let's try another thing. So that is... how's this? That's, it's kind of stringy. I don't like that. It is. I've kind of honestly, oh, here's the one I use for Silva specifically. It's a little bright. I don't know. I kind of, after a while, it's kind of hard not to just want to give up, you know? Like, I don't want to be a downer, but after a while, you kind of just stop trying and just do it because you like to, because you're not gonna get anywhere. Let's see. Galaxy here. God, that hurts. That hurts. I don't like it. Gradient here. Bear's doing pretty good. He's actually working on some side projects that keep him pretty busy. I know right now, that's not bad. That's not what I want. I know right now he's working on some side projects that keep him pretty busy. Wrestling 2K or whatever it is, just recently, posture check, thank you, just recently came out, so he's been kind of dealing with that, That's actually just for adding blue tips. Well, that means a lot to me, eh? Maybe I just don't work it myself right, you know? It's a lot to do when you have a full-time job and hobbies on top of that. As it is this weekend, I have to do my cosplay shoots for the month. I try to do them a month ahead of time, but what the hell was my hair? I mean, I know my hair's right there. My hair's right here, but I meant the textures I was looking for. I was looking for textures. I can find them. Apple to... Can't say I've been in a huge hurry to sign off, since this is kind of a pretty chill thing to do, and it's probably something I'd be working on anyway, so. That. See, this is essentially what I do. I will find a million different ones, and then I will slowly narrow them down until I find the ones I like. I actually thought about giving her darker hair at one point. Like, her demon version would have darker hair. Kind of like that, almost, but I don't know, she wears such dark colors, I almost think she shouldn't have darker hair. There's a select few yellows that I don't think look too bad. But, I'm definitely not a fan, of most yellow. Definitely not a fan of most yellow, and I don't mind, like, pastel in certain additions, kind of like her hairpins and stuff, but when it comes to most other things, like, I don't know, like, Well, I try to keep her aesthetically pleasing. I have a very fine line between an appropriate level of texture and too much fucking texture. That green hair is pretty. So shiny. Very particular when it comes to oh God, what is this? Sunflower patterns aren't bad. Can't say I really mind sunflower patterns. I don't wear a lot of sunflower patterns, but I don't think I really mind sunflower patterns either. They can look nice. Is pretty. I really like how it does it on the lower areas, but maybe. Ocean Sapphire. Always appreciated pastel. I am not a pastel person. I don't know if I'm like there. Like, I've always loved pastel, but I just cannot do pastel. It's very shiny. Shit, prism hair. Oh, God. My fucking retinas. It hurts. It hurts so much. Let's see. Red. Well, the thing is, if I find a texture I like, I can always change the color. This is white. interesting. One thing I do really like is the fact that many of these have, now that it's VR Studio, not just VROID, or VROID Studio, they have an entire different section for hair highlights, which is super useful because it just doesn't look as good as, no, it doesn't look good at all. That looks good with some really specific, let's delete them. Okay, so watercolor looks very nice. Maybe it is color. No, that's not gonna work. It's not gonna work. Let's delete that. So that's not bad. But I feel like it's just the same thing with just like a slightly different color tone. I have an idea. Watercolor, but at the same time, I feel like without anything to actually like make everything else look watercolor, it just looks really weird. How it's darker and lighter at the bottom? Well, maybe. Alright, I feel like I'm gonna have to adjust some things so that, like, specifically the lower areas, like the sideburns,
It's so bright. Go away.
bright. It's still so bright! I wonder if I can... Soft light doesn't look so bad. I do kind of like the highlights in this one. I think it's very shiny and pretty. So this is called Vroid Studio. It is a free program that is available on Steam. Likes this one because it's a little darker, but it's not like too dark. That's the one I have to worry about. Oh, look at that. That's the... Free is nice, and a lot of people actually use this as their a lot of people use this for when they're making VTubers. Change this to have support the highlights. Oh, well. We can change this to have... that. And then... that. Then I think this one was... hue or color? Then we will need to adjust the ears just a smidge. Wait, where are their ears? There we go. Now accessories are where the color needs to change. Way too high still. It'd be so much easier if I could do this. Tablet. that's a little bit of difference. Yeah, okay. I really should fix the outfit somehow. I don't know, I like this, but it's not what I want. This makes me bothered. Now. may just have to work. Not that one. Not a skirt. A dress. Oh yeah. Forgot I had a bunch of stuff that I kind of tried over it. Figure out what I liked. The great thing about this is you can technically import things separately. It's like, for example, oh, that is a shadow, that is not what I wanted. For example, you can import pieces of things separately, like a bow. And then something else, and it can do it in a layer method. Like, for example, I can do that and then put a skirt over it. It's kind of cool. I mean, it's very interesting because you can kind of layer a lot of things and choose what you want. I've been listening to the exact same thing over and over and over again for hours. Oh, chains. Cards. Funny thing is, like, it's set up. It's set up to be a station, but for some reason, apparently that was the only thing on the station. There isn't porn that appeals to children on YouTube. Technically speaking, there shouldn't be porn at all on YouTube. Because, I mean, hell, my Honey Pop video got flagged for being inappropriate, even though I censored everything. Thank you. strongly suggest reporting that, because I feel like that's something that should be on YouTube. I'll probably stick with this for a while. Oh yeah, no, a lot of models and cosplayers and everything have had a lot of issues with putting things on social media because they get threatened with having things taken down. Even though they're not inappropriate, but then some people are totally fine having, like, grossly inappropriate stuff up, and nothing happens. Well, I guess the dress will just have to stay for now. That it was that late. So we're going to go ahead and call it quits here. Oh, okay. That's not really what I expected you to do, but, crouching doesn't really work with the dress. Here, while we're here, background, I don't know. Oh, you can even change your facial expression. That's pretty cool. I like that. All right. So, that being said, thank you guys for joining me for this incredibly long stream. I didn't expect it to go on as long, but good news, everyone. I have purchased the newest Jackbox Party Pack, so we are going to be playing that on Friday as a sort of thank you to all of all the things that you guys have kind of, you know, stuck with. So we will be doing Jackbox Friday, and I hope all of you have a wonderful evening, and I will see you on the next episode. Love you, darlings.